Por siempre la llamaré preciosa. Yo sé de sus hembras trigueñas, sé del olor de sus rosas. Por eso a mi tierra riqueña, por siempre la llamaré preciosa.
The whole body remembers. Even Crazy Top won't forget it, and he doesn't even know where his mother got buried. But man, first let's have a couple of beers. Bartender! Because this damn head is killing me, man. So, the story starts.
It was 4 years ago, but I won't mention the day because you already know that. Turns out that day I had told the foreman, a Jewish fellow, nice guy, that knows a bit of Spanish, that I wanted some overtime because I would need the dough for my wife's pregnancy because she was in her final months. So at 4 o'clock, I finished my first shift and went down to the Italian snack bar in front of the factory. I was eating a hot dog with beer while I flipped the Spanish paper that I bought in the morning. I was reading about this Latino who had caught up with his girlfriend because she had been running around with a Chinaman. But I don't know if you don't believe in those kind of things, but I had a funny feeling. I felt something big was gonna happen that night.
Say, buddy, you wanna become a billionaire and have a casino in Puerto Rico?
Casino? I already have a casino. I wanna open a factory.
What kind of factory?
Smoke factory.
Oh, really? And what are you gonna do about the smoke?
I'm gonna can it.
Say, buddy, someone looking for you.
Yeah, dude, you don't even know what's that name. What happened,
Chris? Hey, buddy, go home. Your wife's having a baby.
Hi, mi madre.
Foreman. What's the trouble?
My wife's having a baby.
Well, what are you waiting for?
I have to punch my car.
I'll do it for you. Just go.
Let's go, Chris. Hurry up, you're gonna close the train, get inside. Hurry up, man.
So, we got to the Columbia Circle and changed trains because we had to go to 110th and 5th to get home. I was counting the minutes, wondering if my son had already been born and how my wife was. Suddenly, it occurs to me, here I am. So, sure I'll be a boy, and what if it winds up being a girl? Truth is, it's selfishness on our part because it's better for the mother that the eldest is a girl so she can help with the housework and raising the little ones. And then in a moment when I was feeling very much like a father, but then, BAM! The lights go out and the train starts to lose power and stuff right in the middle of the-
Come on, this happened today.
Say, buddy.
What happened, Chrissy Top?
I peed my pants, Ring.
Seriously, Chrissy Top? You know, you could have gone before getting inside the train. You know there's no possible way of peeing in here.
I have been waiting so much time and I can't wait much longer.
Chrissy Top, let me see what I can do for you, okay? Just has to take a leak.
God damn it, can he wait a little longer?
Come on, just look at him. His name is Crazy Tom. He's really crazy. He just can't wait. He's just like a child.
Dude, there's a blackout and he's not safe here.
But come on, well, he's gonna pee inside the train. You wanna clean it up after he does it?
Well, okay, go ahead, but don't go too far.
You can open the doors?
Okay.
Thank you. Come on, over here. Chrissy Top, you just permission to go outside. go see if we can find a way back in the back there with the train.
I can't hold it anymore.
Just keep going. There's too much people in here. Here, man, run. Okay, this is the thing. Just get behind me in the wall and just try to take a leap. Just sit in there. I got mine, there's people coming. Come on, Chrissy Top, you've been there for a minute. Hurry up, man, are you done?
I'm done.
You're done already? You got my shoes all wet. We're done? Come on, let's go.
Wait, I'm shaking it.
Hurry up, man. We gotta go. Now the best part comes. Were you in New York that day?
No, now I'm Puerto Rico.
Okay, man. I'm gonna tell you this part of the story, but first let's just get a couple more beer. Bartender, two medallas, please. Now, as I was saying, where are the damn keys? Open up. Where's my wife? Where is she? Where is she?
She's in the bathroom. She's fine. She did cook.
She's fine?
First. Yes, she did cook.
I didn't think how good that you got here. I was worried about you. Our son looks like you. Come see him. Look.
Wow, it just looks like me quite a bit.
He doesn't look like me or anybody else. He looks like a newborn mouse.
Just a little boy, just what you wanted.
Well, let's see if next time we can make a nice pair.
Well, what are you gonna name him? Well, Jose, just like his papa, so he won't forget his kids he is.
Well, maybe if you want to. Is there a party?
It seems so, because we've been hearing it for a while.
But a party with no light?
Maybe they did the same as we did. Went out and bought candles.
Hey, buddy, come here.
What's happening? Come on, let's get to the roof. Hurry up, man.
What do you see?
The moon.
And what else?
Stars.
Ave Maria, muchacho. I don't know if you're going to believe me, but it was like a dream. The moon was huge, like it was made of gold, and the whole sky was full of stars, just like in Puerto Rico. It had been so long since I had seen the sky because of the glow of millions of electric bulbs that are turned on here every night. And we had already forgotten that the stars existed.
It seems we're not the only ones celebrating.
It was true. I can't tell you how many rooftops in the barrio there were parties that night. Well, there were quite a few, because when our combo stopped playing, we could hear music from other places nice and clear. Then I thought of so many things. I thought of my newborn son and what his life would have been like here. I thought of so many things that I've already forgotten some of them, because you know that your mind is like a blackboard and time is like an eraser that scoops across it when it's full. But what I'll always remember is what I said to then Doña Lula, which is what I want to tell you now to finish my story. And that is, according to my poor way of understanding things, that was the night that we became people again.